Yes, sir. We are very, very honored that you came for this victory service. You are very aware that today is a celebration service in honor of the prophetic validation of Prophet Marcus' prophecy concerning the presidential election in Nigeria 2019, whereby he prophesied and he predicted accurately that President Muhammadu Buhari is going to come back second time. And we are not going to forget that in 2014 he also predicted that the president is going to win the election and discard the former president Goodluck Jonathan. First of all, sir, I want to know your name and how do you feel about the prophecy and the service of victory?
Thank you very much for the being international. My name is Elabelu Ojo, popularly, and I want to be on your side because your TV or your YouTube program actually was the one that caused confusion for me. I was almost beaten up. You won't believe it that I have been excommunicated even from my Christian Union group.
Why, sir?
Yes, because I told them the gospel truth that great is the mystery of godliness. When people don't believe, when they don't know exactly what it takes to be a prophet, they cannot, churchgoers nowadays cannot differentiate between a churchgoer, a pastor, a teacher, and a prophet. They have forgotten that a nation that has no prophet is just walking in the darkness. And your YouTube program was actually what made me to be more interested, even in this thing. And I told some people, in fact, there was a man, an elderly man, 94 years old. The first day he saw me, he called me and told me, sir, I heard that you know Prophet TV. Yes, I am MK. I said, yes, sir, that I met him on YouTube. And the way he attended to me was so fantastic. He said he would like to know him. I said, sir, don't bother yourself. You are too old. Just send me to him. I'll be able to deliver your message. And sincerely speaking, the day he touched that book, the book of Revelation, he was never the same again.
He was never the same again.
At all. And you believe that this man studied in the UK. After 40-something years in UK, he came back to Nigeria. That want to make sure that the things he saw in UK happened at his own time. But that he has never seen a prophet such like this. I said, glory be to God. By the time I told people that they should go and watch your YouTube, especially that of December 31st.
Okay, sir.
My oh my.
That's the
crossover night.
Yeah.
When the prophet said that God is doing a new thing in the life of President Buhari, and that a lot of people will run away after the presidential election. They said, go and sit down. You have come again. You always market people. I say, I'm not a marketer. I'm saying what God said through his prophet. And if you believe the prophet, you want to obtain the prophet's reward. So that was where my problem started. By the time the election was coming up, and I took those books to some churches, they sent me away. They said, no. Somebody told me that if Buhari wins the election, president wins the election, he's going to buy the books. I laughed. I said, why not collect the book, buy it before you see? He said, no, it's too much. How can you say the whole lot? Say everybody is for Atiku. I said, please remove my name, remove my vote, and remove my family. I said, I'm not articulated. I'm only following the word of God that says that this nation must be changed. And the thieves and those people that have embezzled our money, no matter how highly placed they are, they will pay for it. That was it. Immediately, I sent it to my members in the WhatsApp group. They said, who is this idiot? I said, you call me an idiot? They said, who is this man? He's rubbish. He's talking nonsense. They should delete him. How did he get to our group? A Christian group that we have been since 1979. Now calling me a fool because I told them that Atiku will not win, Buhari will win. That is all. They removed my name, bam, and they blocked me, boom. I said, and I just sent a letter before they removed. I said, you can remove my name from your group, but you cannot remove my name from the book of life because I told you the truth and you will not obey the truth. Therefore, your sins will go after you. And I told them, I just smiled. I sent that, smile something. Yeah. I said, time will tell. And they say bye-bye to me. I say bye-bye. So after some time, the other group, they saw the same thing again. They were annoyed. Say, why should it be you again, a poor pastor? I said, put pastoral something apart. This is something that has to do with destiny. This man is destined to rule this nation for another 4 years. And whether you like it or not, Nigeria will change. They say, no, this man cannot do it. He's weak. God is going to use his weakness to confound you and to confront you. And thank God that we have seen the truth. And this is just the beginning. If Sharaki can be disgraced like that in Kwara. But remember one thing, he offended his father. And cause causeless shall not come. And because he offended his own father cursed him. How do you expect somebody to pray for him and say that he's going to win? Those people that refuse to pay their tax, that they are making merchandise of us in the churches, and they are telling us that the Buhari will not win, is because the axe has been placed upon the root of the tree, and the tree must surely fall down.
It must fall down.
It has started falling, and unless they repent and turn away from their wickedness and come back to the man of God and say, "Sir, we are sorry. We didn't know it was like that." That is when their sins can be forgiven. But for them to support iniquity and to add iniquity to iniquity and to continue to live in sin and to make people harsh for the people of Nigeria, it shall never go well with them. I'm not cursing them. I'm only saying what the Bible says. Say unto the righteous, it shall be well with him. And to the wicked, well, it shall not be well with him. Okay, so thank you, Asebe, because you have done a nice job. In fact, I'm proud of you. If I have a way to even take you to other places, but my prophet has said, ride on. Don't be afraid. Nothing should shake you, and you continually to rise high. It is well with you.
Sir, how do you now, apart from the issue of the church,
yep.
What do you have to say? We've seen a lot of big pastors who came to prophesize, someone like Bishop David Oyedepo, saying that nobody is going to vote for a murderer, a killer. Even his assistant bishop, Abidoye, also was preaching, convincing the Christian community not to vote for President Buhari. Someone like one pastor, Bodunshe or something like that, in South Africa, who said the president is going to die before the election, that even during the campaigning, he will die along the campaign. And people like one Prime Minister of Dile, that is somewhere called Inri, that has also been protesting that Saraki is going to use his glory to bless Atiku, and Atiku will win because Saraki is working with him. He initially said Saraki is going to be the president of Nigeria, but when Saraki failed in the primary, he said the glorious Saraki is going to help that of Atiku. And some other legions like Pastor Joshua Johnson Suleiman, all of them that gave all sort of fictitious prediction. You as a man of God and as a decent apostle of Jehovah Lord God, what advice do you have for them? And do you think the Christian community in Nigeria is in danger?
Yeah, number one, the Christian community is the enemy of itself, beginning from the top, especially those who call themselves men of God. But the Bible says, by their fruits ye shall know them. Most of them, they are serving their bellies, and they are their own God. They believe so much in themselves. When you don't live a righteous life, it is impossible for you to correct somebody who is living righteously, who is living in sin. I'm sorry to say, you made mention of Bishop Oyedepo.
Yes, sir.
I remember in 1984, 85, when we were in Kaduna, vividly, if you can remember, he sent somebody to me to join his church. And I told that brother, I said, "Sir, I am too small to join such a church, but I will not join because there are things that we believe that he doesn't believe. I don't want to mention some other names." So immediately you said Oyedepo. You should have asked, why was he saying that?
Yeah, why did
he? He didn't pay his tax. He has 5 jets, parking space, no tax, nothing. Is that a leader?
No, sir. I don't think so, sir. That's harmful to the economy.
He's afraid because if our president comes back, he knows that he's going to pay to the last kobo. This is somebody, the man of God here, prophet, sent a message to him. Rather than him coming to him, Nicodemus came to Jesus in the night. So there's nothing wrong for you to come to a prophet in the night. You may be a bishop, you may be any name you are called. But one thing is this, everybody has his own ministry. If you stay on your own ministry, you will not go astray. This is a prophet that God has given to us. Why not him come to him? Philip was with the other disciples. Those women came, they said, "Sir, we will see Jesus," which means they could not recognize Jesus because of his humility. He was dressing like his other apostles. You hardly can know any difference. If you come here, you hardly know the difference between the prophet and the other people, other members of the ministry.
Yes, sir.
That is humility. So you should be able to humble yourself and walk in a way that people will know that you have the fear of God. But many of these people, they don't have the fear of God. Number two, when you are so money conscious, there's no way you can be able to preach the true gospel. Everything is not money. So you must have the fear of God, be able to preach the word of God. And again, the Bible says that, woe unto that prophet that says, when God have not said. So what further proofs do we need? to tell people that most of these people, they are doing it just, they are doing eye service. Because they said that Boko Haram, this is and that, that is why he wants to turn Nigeria into a religious Islamic country. Is it possible?
It's not possible, sir.
Nigeria is so homogeneous. Nobody can try it.
Yes,
nobody, not even the president. Not even the president, because he himself, he is tired of this Islamic something.
Yeah.
Only because he cannot just say it out.
Yes.
I have every reason to believe him.
Yes.
So, and this is the man who wants to serve and help this nation and bring back the glory of Nigeria. Mm. People are now against him. Why? Because of their selfish interests. Yes, people who are not paying tax. Oyedepo is not paying. And a lot of people that have ruined the economy, they are bringing ties to his church.
Mm.
How can he rebuild such people? Mm. It's not possible.
Mm.
People should be, you know, they should be wary of such people. They should be wary because they lack the truth and they don't want to live by the truth.
Mm.
And by the grace of God, God will help our president.
Amen, sir.
He has started well, he will end well.
Amen,
and
sir.
For those soothsayers,
yes,
let them pray. Let them gather together. The Bible says they shall surely gather together, but not on me. If they come against him in one way, they will flee in seven ways. Because say unto the righteous, it shall be well with him.